Have you seen this edit?
It's time to eliminate loose ends. Besides, who would you be without me?
I am Megatron.
My name is Kelvin Dela, a video editor, and today I'll be teaching you how to make the Premiere-style edit you have been seeing on TikTok using just Adobe Illustrator, Canva, and your video editing software, CapCut. So first, what you're going to need is your project files, which includes your audio, your two black screens, and then the 8 pictures or videos you want to include in it. So let's get started. What we're going to do next is open your video editing software, and for this tutorial, we'll be using CapCut. Hold on, let it open up. Yes, we'll be using CapCut for this one. So next thing we're going to do is create a new project. And then you first thing you do is import your 8 pictures or videos you want to use. You can choose to use this or use actual pictures or videos. I'll be using this as a template, which I'll also include the link in the description so you can use for your TikTok videos. What you are going to do next is create a folder. I like to organize my work so that I'll know where everything is, and I'll name this media. Save. Now what we are going to do is move these 8 inside here. We'll create a new folder and rename that folder assets. So this is where we have our black screen, our audio, and anything else we are going to add. But for this, we are going to adjust our black screen and our audio. Okay, so first thing you want to do is import your audio, and the next thing you're going to do is import your first media inside. So you want to stretch this to the end so you know what you're working with. And then the next thing we're going to do is we'll go to your assets folder, and then you import your black screen. Just import it once, you copy and paste, and you stretch that one to also to the end of the video. Now what we are going to do is we'll move the black screens, we'll move one up and then we'll move one down. So we'll move this one up, we'll move the other one down. Okay, so what we are going to do is we'll change the Y value for this to be -1432. So it will come up a bit, and we'll change this one to 1432. Perfect. All right, so after you set your, you have to insert a keyframe, we will do that. But first you set their initial position. The bottom one will be -1432 and the upper one will be +1432. So now what we are going to do next is insert a keyframe at the beginning, right at the start. So you send it to the start, and then you move the keyframe close to the end when it's about to end. So right here, we'll select the upper one and we'll move it up until we cannot see it again. Make sure it doesn't shift left or right, and we'll do the same to the bottom one. Move it down till we cannot see it again. So at the end, we are going to have something like this. Right, so what we want to do is move, yes, exactly. So this is what we are going to have something like this. Yes, what we are going to do next is very simple. So now we're going to play it again, and you pay attention to, we are going to be splitting the clips. Yes, basically. So you pay attention to what I'm about to do. Every time you hear a change, in the sound, you split it. And right about right here, we're going to split it again. That's when we have our black screen. Always remember to turn off the auto snapping. Right here again. And about here. And here again. Around here. Break it down here again. Here, and then finally here. So after the breaking, this is what you're going to, you're going to have 8 separate medias on the timeline. So reduce our volume a bit and play it. I have something like this. Now what we are going to do is we will import our other 8. We are going to replace the clips. Perfect. So now after importing all your clips, when you play it back, you're going to have something like this. Perfect. What you're going to do now is we are going to add the filter, because it has a black and white filter. So what you're going to do is look for, you go to filter and you go to featured and you look for BW3, black and white 3, and you add that one right at the top. So you're not really going to see the effects because it's in black and white, but if we're supposed to add a different video, hold on, make sure it's in there. It's supposed to add like a different picture that's not black and white. You are going to see the effect of it. So for now, I'm just going to keep what we're going to use for our template. Next thing we want to add is your noise, because when you look at the edits, you can see noise, some noise thingy on it. It's something like there are some things on the screen. What you're going to do is you go straight to effect, and on top here you're going to type noise. You search for noise. There are different effects you're going to get, but then we are looking for a specific one, which is black noise. Yes, so you are going to add it to it. That's the specific one I'm looking for. You stretch it to the end. We are going to have something like this. So if you're getting something like this so far, you're good to go. Okay. So right now we are basically done with our edits. This is the basic one. When you look at some of it, you can see there are text on the screen and all. So in our next video, we are going to learn how to add text to it as an overlay, just like how the others look like. And then apart from the text as well, we're also going to learn how to insert an intro sound, just like what we saw in the preview. So if you have watched so far to this part of the video, I want you to leave a like and subscribe, join the family. If you have questions, contact me by email to ask me the question, and join my social media platforms where I post the templates I make from the edits. And if you find any edits or any templates and you need a tutorial for, do well to tag me on any social media. Or you can email me the link and describe what you want to learn, and I'm going to make a free video and post it here on YouTube for you guys. Also, I'm going to be posting this as a template on my TikTok channel, and insert the link in the description where you can use this template whatever you want to use for. It's totally free. So thanks for joining me on my first video. Look forward to seeing you soon.